Combustion Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Dan Hewitt. With a breather between all these spacewalks, it was time for some serious science. NASA's Joe Acaba replaced a controller in the combustion integrated rack for the upcoming Advanced Combustion via Microgravity experiment, or ACME. The rack provides a safe environment for studies that literally start fires in space, and ACME will study 5 different gaseous flames. All of this aims to improve fuel efficiency and reduce pollution in combustion processes here on Earth, while also learning the best ways to prevent fires in space. Simultaneously, NASA's Mark VandeHei was preparing the newest batch of space crops. This will be the 5th run of the ongoing VEG-03 experiment, producing a mix of cabbage, lettuce, and mizuna, also known as Japanese mustard greens. The veggie experiments are continuing to expand our ability to grow fresh foods in microgravity, something mission planners are hoping will be an integral part of the food supply for future long-duration missions, especially those that fly way beyond the Earth. And a big part of the station turned 10 this week. The European Columbus module flew into space back on February 7, 2008, in the payload bay of the shuttle Atlantis. It was attached using the station's robotic arm just 2 days later, where it's been a science hub ever since. The module houses experiments from across the spectrum, including material science, fluid physics, life science, and technology development. It also has space for external experiments, including the very popular high-definition Earth viewing platform. Keep sending in questions using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.